Hello everyone, I'm Pooja Sinha and with me I have my colleague Aditi Gangwar, and today we're going to talk to you about the PDF Reader in Microsoft Edge, which meets the needs of everyone in your organization, addressing everyday scenarios such as inking and specialized scenarios such as information protection. Also, do watch our previous video talking about 5 things you should know about the PDF Reader in Microsoft Edge, the link for which has been added in the description below. Today, in addition to existing capabilities, we'll be talking to you about 3 new announcements: cross-tenant support for MIP-protected PDF files, improved support for digital signature validation, and a surprise announcement. Do sign up at aka.ms/edgepdfpreview to know more about it. Now, we will take you through a demo of the PDF Reader. Now let's take a scenario where a publishing company, Contos Book Publishing, needs to get into a contract with a partner, Woodgrove, for usage of their SaaS services. Woodgrove has sent over the service contract for review. They have filled in relevant details like pricing and the services under the contract. Now, I need to fill in the details for my company, and I will do just that. Let me fill in the address. I will review the rest of the contract. Seems like I need to fill in my company details here. I'll fill in my name and my designation. Now, I can see that my signature would be required for the contract, but before I do that, I want to review the payment schedule. Since this document has a table of contents for easy navigation, I will open the contents pane, navigate to the relevant section, which is payment of fees, and review it. Now, I can mark the content that I want my legal team to review and leave a comment through text notes. I can scroll back up the document and leave my signature. In order to do that, I will click on the inking tool to select the color that I want to sign with, choose the right amount of thickness, and then sign the document. Now that I've made all the changes that I want to do with the document, I can save this and share it with my legal team using the share option. I can choose mail and email the contract to my colleague.
Now let's talk about the announcements that Pooja made, that is MIP protected PDF files and validating digital signatures. Talking about MIP, what exactly is it? For those of us who are new here, MIP stands for Microsoft Information Protection. What it basically does is that it ensures that the data of your organization remains secure both within and outside the boundaries of your organization. It ensures that only the users who have access to a certain file can access it and take only the actions that are permitted to them. We announced the support for viewing MIP-protected files within the tenant about a year back, and it has been adopted by quite a few enterprises. Thank you for that. And now we've also added support for viewing MIP-protected PDF files between 2 different business tenants. For example, if your organization works with another organization very closely, users can exchange MIP-protected PDF files and continue the work seamlessly. They don't need any additional licensing. There's no additional add-in or extension that needs to be required or upgraded. So things work very seamlessly without any overheads. If you want to know more about it, please do sign up at aka.ms/hpdfpreview. And before I forget, the support is available across Windows and Mac. So it's right there wherever you need it. Talking about digital signatures, it has been a huge ask from enterprises as well, and we've been constantly working on it. About 6 months back, we launched a preview for validating digital signatures, where if a file had certificate-based digital signatures in it, you would see an additional icon in the tab. Clicking on the icon would give you more details about the validity and more information about the signature. Since then, we have added support for PKCS1 signatures as well, and we've worked on 2 major features. One is honoring signature permissions. Whenever an author signs a PDF document, they can configure as to what actions users can take on the PDF document without invalidating the signature. For example, they can say whether the document can be modified in terms of filling a form or maybe adding more signatures or maybe inking and annotating on it without invalidating the signature itself. Hence, Microsoft Edge now honors the permissions that the user had set initially, and the validation status that you see takes that into account. We've also further built on the security that the PDF reader in Microsoft Edge had and added a secure mode. This ensures that the validation status that you see has not been tampered with and is the correct status. Now let's jump into a quick demo of both the things.
Now let's talk about MIP. Suppose you're Contoso Book Publishing, who's a book publisher, and you're working with Adiquan at Microsoft.com to publish a book authored by them. Hence, there's a PDF file that you have that should be accessible only to Adiquan at Microsoft.com and to admin at Contoso Book Publishing.onmicrosoft.com because they are the publishers and to no one else. What MIP basically does is, if there's a PDF file that's protected by them, it'll ensure that no one else can actually open the file. If they try to, they would see a prompt saying that they need permissions. And the same file, if the users who have the access for it open, then they would be able to see the file seamlessly without the need of any other extension, without the need of any other add-in, and across Windows and Mac. It's that seamless. They can also validate what permissions they have on the document. Again, they just need to sign into the browser and they would be able to view the files that are there. And as you can see, this works across business tenants now. This is Adiquan at Microsoft.com. And this is admin at ContosoBookPublishing.onMicrosoft.com. And they're both able to access the same file simply because MIP has given the permission to. It's really that seamless. And talking about digital signatures, suppose the PDF file that Jane Doe had shown had a certificate-based digital signature on it. Let's see how it would look. There would be a new icon that appears in the toolbar which says digital signatures. And it would also have a banner saying that the document is digitally signed and the validity of the signature. As you can see, here they can see whether the signer's identity was valid or not and whether the document has been modified or not. Click on Properties gives them more details. Now, this is what we're talking about today. While signing, an author can tell whether the signature should retain its validity when the document is signed again or the form fields are filled. As you can see, the author is not given the permission for commenting. Now, suppose someone had actually gone out of the way and inked the file. Let's see what would happen. They would see that the signature is invalid. As you can see, there's ink on the document, and it's very clearly communicated here. The signature is invalid because the document has modifications that are not allowed. It's really that simple. And again, this is available across both Mac and Windows, and it works seamlessly in your organization without the need of any add-in. And we are ensuring that we take into account the permissions that are given by the author while telling you the validity of the signature.
Everything we talked about comes with complete accessibility support. We have added support for high contrast mode, screen readers, and keyboard-only navigation. Additionally, we've also enabled carrot mode that lets you navigate PDF documents and markup content using just your keyboard. The PDF reader in Microsoft Edge can be used across the Windows, Mac, and Linux devices in your organization, meeting users where they are. So how do you get all of this awesomeness in your organization? All you have to do is go through a few easy steps. You can go through the documentation at aka.ms/deploy-edge and pilot by downloading the Microsoft Edge offline installers. You can deploy and manage Microsoft Edge using several convenient programs such as App Assure, FastTrack, and Unified Support. Thank you so much for your love and support over the last year as we made our journey to build a PDF reader that meets your needs. To know more, please go to aka.ms/deploy-edge-pdf and visit aka.ms/edge-pdf-preview to sign up for our upcoming previews. Also, do watch our previous video talking about 5 things you should know about the PDF reader in Microsoft Edge, the link for which has been added in the description below. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you.